Hey guys, welcome back. We are here with our good friend Sam Houston, and we're gonna be talking about laser divergence. Basically, how big does that laser dot get at distance? Where we had the idea come from was I was on a pig hunt recently. We lased these pigs out to about 160 yards. I went to shoot them with the laser and illuminator. The laser dot was as big as the pig's face, so I had to back off the laser, keep the illuminator, and shoot through my aim point to properly engage that pig, because I couldn't tell. So we're here with Sam tonight, and we're going to get our knowledge on.
Cool. Yep, laser divergence. What is laser divergence? Again, it's the bloom of the laser at various distances. Think of it kind of like, to relate it to shooting terms, kind of your cone of deviation as far as how big your group is going to be. At 100 yards, you could, you know, maybe in theory hold a group like that. At 200, it's going to start opening up and progressively larger and larger groups. In theory, on a gun, the further you get from the muzzle. Same thing with divergence. The divergence is going to get bigger as we increase distance from the laser. And, you know, all of these lasers that we have two lasers. We're running a MAL C1 Plus, which is your civilian legal low power B.E. Myers offering. And then we also had a MAL DA, which is your full throttle high power class 3 laser. And we are going to talk about and show our effects of the laser on the targets at 100, 200, 300, and then we're going to go out to about 700 meters and show you that. And we've got a couple of shots for you guys of what it looks like through the tube. So just because you see what we see at, you know, 2 yards with us downrange is not necessarily what's going to translate for the end user actually at the rifle. So keep that in mind. But that's laser divergence. You know, I could get a whole lot more deep in the weeds on lasers, but there's really no need. Just want you guys to understand, at the end of the night, probably the biggest takeaway when it comes to lasers is lasers are not precision engagement instruments. All right, they are meant to put a combat effective round on a man-sized target within, you know, practical distances. What are practical distances? Well, that's kind of subjective, but anywhere from about 50 to 150 meters. Some people are really, really skilled and can take it out a little bit further, but realistically, you know, 200 to 300 in there is about the extent as far as engaging with a, you know, an infantry type weapon with a laser. Anything past that, you're gonna probably need some precision. So you're talking about a clip-on night vision device and some magnification, which is a whole different type of sighting targeting system versus a laser. But we're gonna take it out and show you what we see, so.
All right guys, so we're gonna start off at 100 yards, go to 2, 3, and then 7.
So the first distance is going to be 100 yards. You'll notice visually represented, you're going to see a bright, intense hot spot that is the center of the laser. And then you may see some concentric rings, think, you know, a cross-section of a tree with the rings in the trunk of the tree. And generally speaking, we're not going to take into account the you know, far outer rings. We're probably only going to measure maybe one ring or two concentric rings out from that, you know, center intense hotspot if we do measure the rings.
At 100 yards, the C1 Plus, the center of that ring with the illuminator was about 2.5 to 3 inches. And then without the illuminator, we were looking at about 5-ish inches. But when we looked at it ourselves just now, it, from the shooter's perspective at 100 yards, it looks to be about 12. So just so going forward, you know that the measurements that you see at 2 yards versus what we see here is going to be vastly different. So, and like we said, it's...
And the reason you're going to see that is because these things amplify light like 6,000 or 7,000 times. So yeah, it's going to amplify that 5 inches across to about 12 inches at distance with these things.
Yeah. And so that was with the C1 Plus. The full power laser, it was about 3.5 all the way with the illuminator up to about 6 or 7 when it was just the laser itself without the illuminator. Then we pushed back to 200. 200 with the C1 Plus was about a 6-inch hotspot with the illuminator up to about 7 or 8 inches with just the laser. The full power was 9 or 10 inches. Pushing out to now with the full power laser up to the core hotspot was about 6, but the rings we were seeing at about 16 to 18 inches. So we're already at 200 yards getting a very large dot.
300?
Yep. 300 with the full power. The high intensity spot was 6 inches, but really with the rings we were seeing about 12, and then with the laser by itself we were seeing about a 12 inch ring.
And that was with, sorry, that wasn't full power. That
I'm
was
sorry.
The C1 Plus.
Yeah, C1 Plus. Full power was a 12 inch ring with the illuminator. The hot spot on just the laser was about 6 to 8 inches, and then, but really with the rings, we were seeing almost 2 feet at 300 yards. And so then we decided to double it and give it to the next guy, pushed out to 700 yards. The C1 Plus was 18 inches, and it was, the rings were off the paper with the illuminator. And then the full power one was about 24 inches. The full power was as big as the paper with the illuminator, and then the full power thing, the full power laser by itself without the illuminator was the paper. It was just a massive dot at that point. And those paper, that paper is 24 by 36.
Yep. Basically, what we're getting at is the further you are away from the target, your refined aiming point becomes less and less and less refined.
But yeah, so this was just, all this was tonight was just a data point for everyone. Your laser, whether it be a C1 Plus or full power, everything's gonna be a little bit different. This is just a rough approximation of what we saw tonight with our lasers, just to give you an idea of what you could probably see with yours at those distances. We really appreciate you guys coming out here with us tonight. And thank you, Sam, for making the trip down.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
A quick tip, guys, if you're doing this test or shooting at distance and you're not getting that crisp laser beam that you think you have or you need to have, Q-tips and alcohol. Keep your laser emitters clean. We actually ran into some problems filming. We had to go through 2 different lasers to find a clean one because guys, they actually shoot their gear, and you know, you need to take care of it and clean it every once in a while. Keep those emitters clean, and they'll actually be able to perform better at distance and give you a more refined, you know, aiming point, as opposed to a dirty one that gives you less illumination, less refined aiming point. So take care of your gear so it takes care of you.
All right, guys, thanks for coming out tonight. I hope you guys learned a lot. If you want to train with Sam, be sure to go over to Green Line Tactical or Warrior Poet Society and sign up with some classes with him. And then, Sam, do you have anything else?
Yeah, if you really want to take a deep dive into night vision and you're kind of wondering where to start, man, a great avenue outlet for you is our Night Ops Summit that we do at Green Line Tactical every year. This year coming up, it will be the weekend of the 16th through the 19th of November. That is the weekend before Thanksgiving, just so you can mark your calendars. But it is it's a symposium type event. It's 4 nights, 3 nights of training, and then 1 night of like fun range demo competition, kind of dog and pony shows on the range. There's going to be, you know, in total, you're looking at over 12 hours of training every day. From start to finish. So it's a big, huge event. There's going to be probably 150 to 200 attendees. We have multiple instructors, some huge names in the night vision and low light industry. And it is centered around night vision and low light training. You don't have to have night vision to attend. There's plenty of low light rifle and pistol stuff going on, and red dot optics for handgun and whatnot. There's force on force. There's, you know, obviously flat range stuff. and there's rifle and pistol stuff, both low light and night vision stuff. There are a limited number of rentals if you want to kind of try before you buy, but you get a night with every instructor that you choose from. So it's kind of like a training buffet plus a whole lot of like daytime lectures and everything. But the meal is catered, there's lodging on site, camping is free, but it is 4 nights of, you know, a deep dive into the night vision realm. Anything and everything, if you can think of it, it's probably gonna happen at the Night Ops Summit. If you're interested in that, again, it's greenlinetactical.com. It's probably gonna be the first thing that pops up on the website, but go check that out. My buddies from Blue Alpha will be there. They're gonna be sponsoring the event. And you guys are definitely going to be shooting the classes too. So
yeah, myself and Kurt attended the first event, or the first time last year, and it was phenomenal. We've been super excited to go back ever since then. So we look forward to seeing you guys there. Head over to Green Line Tactical or Warrior Poet Society for any additional training, and head over to BlueAlphaBelts.com and check out the website.